हरे कृष्णा, शेयरिंग इज नॉट प्रोसेलिटाइजिंग. द वर्ड प्रोसेलिटाइज, विच मीन्स टू कन्वर्ट अदर पीपल टू वन्स ओन बिलीव्स और आइडियाज, इट इज़ यूजुअली यूज इन द रिलीजियस कॉन्टेक्स्ट एंड इट ऑफन हैज़ अ नेगेटिव कॉनोटेशन बिकॉज वेन पीपल हु बिलीव इन सर्टन थाट्स एंड दे बिलीव दैट द थाट्स आर द ट्रूथ and when they think that they have a license to do whatever it takes to get other people to the truth, then often they throw ethics to the winds. They allure financially, they manipulate emotionally, they indoctrinate ideologically, they pressurize politically, and they even threaten physically, somehow or the other, trying to force people to convert. Because of such less than holy attitudes and actions, proselytization often gets a bad name, and rightly so. But all sharing of ideas, even religious ideas, doesn't have to be with this motivation. Okay, suppose a person has been sick with a disease for a long time, and then that person is cured. And when the person is cured, at that time, that person realizes that, oh, after a long time, during which no medicine worked, finally I have found a medicine that cures. And actually, when that patient sees that other people are suffering from this disease, same disease, that person wants to help them be cured, and offers them the medicine appropriately for the cure. Similarly, when we devote ourselves to God, we recognize that we at our core are pure, we at our core are devoted, we at our core are actually spiritual. And when we devote ourselves to God by understanding spiritual wisdom, when we adopt a particular wisdom tradition, we find that it adds meaning to value to our life. It gives us meaning and purpose. It makes us better human beings. So we understand that we were earlier spiritually sick, and now we have become spiritually healed and whole. So when we understand this, naturally we would like to share this with others. And the way to share this with others is by explaining, by explain to others' intelligence, appealing to their intelligence, and by inviting them to share in our joyful experience. And there is nothing wrong with such sharing. Sharing is natural to us as human beings. And we, in fact, every school of thought, every set of ideas that has become influential has actually become influential, gained its influence because it was shared by its founder or founders. Even science, it would not have become influential if it had not been shared. So the Bhagavad Gita, so then if there is sharing that is anyway going to happen, sharing is natural for us human beings, and sharing is going to happen, why should all sharing of ideas be allowed except for sharing of religious ideas? Why should that alone be frowned upon? In fact, if we are going to frown upon sharing of religious ideas, then, or sharing of anything connected with God, then atheism should also not be allowed to be shared. Because if atheism also talks about God, even if it talks in a negative way, it does talk about God. And quite often atheists, atheist preachers, they also, some of them exhibit the same intolerance that, the same intolerance that is exhibited by others who are also going to be, for example, by religious ideologues, extremists, who are intolerant towards non-believers. Similarly, atheists are extremely intolerant, condescending, judgmental towards non-believers in atheism, towards theists. So, how far can we go with such intellectual policing? What we should concern us is not the content of what is being shared, but the method by which it is shared. So So in the free sharing of ideas, there should not be any pressurization. The Bhagavad Gita offers a healthy model of sharing when, after speaking the whole message, Krishna tells Arjuna, Vimrishaitadasheshena yathechasitatha kuru. He says, deliberate deeply on what I have said. Vimrishaitad. And then decide as you want to do. Yathechasitatha kuru. So here, when Krishna says, deliberate and decide what you want to do, what he means essentially is that he is offering a non-judgmental, non-imposing, non-dogmatic call for exploration. Here we see a vision of God, who is traditionally considered to be supreme being, not using his omnipotence to impose his will on people, but he's appealing to human intelligence and independence. He's asking for consideration, deliberation and decision. Now, if the sharing of ideas, be it religious or non-religious, if it happened in this this invitational mood, we would have far lesser strife in the world, and the world would be enriched with far greater wisdom. Thank you. Hare Krishna.